Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
We have Minister of State for Environment, Mr. Babul Supriyo with us. Sir, you are Minister of Environment, but the climate in Bengal seems to be very deteriorating right now.
That's why we need a climate change. The Trinamool Congress gundas and mafias and miscreants who belong to the forest need to be sent back to the forest. That's probably, that's ironic. It's a fantastic coincidence that that's the ministry I have got, pun intended. But on a serious note, whatever Mamata Banerjee is doing is absolutely abnormal. There is no point talking about it every day, because no matter how much of words you use to describe her acts, her demeanor, her body language, her language is going to fall flat in comparison to the deplorable act that she's displaying every day in Bengal.
But I think BJP has also decided to send Jai Shri Ram postcards to the CM, which has irked her more. So do you think this is a...
Yes, surely we'll do that. She has no business getting out of the car, getting people arrested for chanting what they believe in. They can chant Jai Shri Ram, they can chant Allahu Akbar, they can chant in the name of their Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. This is a secular country. Anyone is free to do whatever they want to do. There's no business. What about the dignity of the Chief Minister's chair? You get down off the car, you use language, call them outsiders, give them galis, and the entire thing has to be played on television with a beep. How more worse can it get? So someone around her needs to remind her that this is not something that she can probably do. She can do, and she needs a break. Let her go for a take her entourage and go for one of those sightseeing tours, which she loves to term as a business tour or something like that. Let her do one of that. Let her be humble, accept the people's verdict, do some kind of introspection, and then come back with a calm, composed mind that is befitting that is of a chief minister's post.
But we have seen something unprecedented in Bengal also. Chief Minister went to the BJP office and painted her party symbol on it.
Absolutely bizarre. Tell me what happens. She has law and order. She's the police mantri. She has reduced the police, blackmailed them because they work for the government. Their jobs are at stake. She has blackmailed them to work as Trinamool Congress cadres. What happens if tomorrow I go to Asansol and I try to, paint TNC offices into BJP ones? What is going to happen? Tell me. You think I can't do that? I obviously can do that. But will I do it? No. Because that will only create unrest, more unrest. After the West Bengal people have seen the kind of violence that TMC resorted to during this entire season of politics. So this is the time where you have to get back to the people. You have got their verdict or you have not got it. Work towards the betterment of the people. Why carry on this bizarre activity, this violent activity, and do something which is absolutely unbecoming of a chief minister?
But don't you think the struggle and strife between BJP and TMC in Bengal right now is affecting the development of the people also?
Of course it is, but it is. Why are you blaming BJP? BJP is not in power in West Bengal. BJP is being tortured. BJP is being targeted. And why talk about BJP? These are normal people. Who said that those chanting Jai Shri Ram are BJP supporters? From when did BJP Jai Shri Ram become BJP slogan? From when did it become? BJP did not import Jai Shri Ram to Bengal. It is people's will. It's their freedom. That is FOE, freedom of FOS, freedom of speech. They are free to chant anything they want. Who stops them? And let us see. She has made it into a political slogan and has blamed BJP unfairly for it. That's the reason we have all decided to not only send her Jai Shri Ram postcards, but also get well soon, because something is definitely not right with, Didi's language, body language, frame of mind, or whatever else you want to call it.
So you also spoke about getting a Ram statue in your constituency.
Not constituency. I suggested last night on Twitter, and got a lot of support for it, that if there can be chalks and traffic islands in the name of the greatest of legendary leaders, a political sportsperson, Dev Devis, and everything. Now let's erect a Ram statue in one of these political islands, one of these traffic islands in South Calcutta, close to Didi's place, Kalighat. And we already have a Kali temple there. So there is nothing wrong in having a Ram statue erected in one of those traffic islands. And if Didi doesn't like it, she can always use a detour. She can avoid that particular chalk. And let her say no to our plea to want to make that traffic island there in Kolkata.
So that was Mr. Babul Supriyo for the print, Pragya Kaushik.